called the revaluation account. Now question in your mind that why the assets and liabilities to be revalued? When the partners are changing their profit and loss sharing ratio, till the day the change took place, they want to see what is the present value of asset and liability. So to give the effect of that present value, revaluation means old value and now present value. So whatever is the changes took place in the valuation of asset, it may increase, it may decrease. In the same manner, liability may increase, liability may decrease. Some effect will be there. And because of that change in valuation, profit or loss will arise. So to calculate that profit and loss, revaluation account we are preparing. For your MCQ, you have to remember that what is the another name of revaluation. So revaluation another name is profit and loss adjustment account. This is for your MCQ. Second, how you have to prepare, which rule to be followed to this account. The rule of nominal account is used while preparing the revaluation account. The basic these three should be there in your mind. Now let us see the specimen of revaluation account. This specimen you will find on page number 120 of your textbook. The specimen of revaluation account. Debit side means expense. What the nominal account rule says? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gain. So when you write anything on the debit side, it indicates that it may be an expense or it may be a reduction in the value of an asset. Due to that, loss is there. So let us understand first the debit side. The very first reason that when the asset account value decreases, earlier the plant costing 1 lakh, because we have used today the present value of plant is 80,000. So 1 lakh will be reduced up to 80,000. So 20,000 is the reduction in the value, present value of asset. It indicates the loss. It indicates 1 lakh of expense. So that will return on the debit side. Like that, when you are reconstructing your partnership, you realize that there should be a bad debt reserve created. So if you create bad debt reserve, what kind of expense you are incurring, that will be debited to revaluation account. In the same manner, discount reserve on data. So that also reduce your profit, reduce your, increase your expense. So that will be recorded on debit side. Then you have two liabilities. If the liability increases, for an example, you have purchased goods on credit. So because of that, your bills payable accepted by you, those are increased. That increase your liability, become one kind of a loss or expense for you, that will be debited to revaluation account. Your creditor may increase or bills payable may increase. Next, any outstanding expense. You have outstanding salary or outstanding rent or outstanding wages. On the day when you are changing your profit and loss ratio, on that day, whatever outstanding expense are there, become expense for you to be recorded on debit side. So in this manner, all expenses and losses, what possibilities are there, all will come on debit side of revaluation account. Now then on the credit side means income and gain, all benefit, all profit, all probability of income to be recorded. Now expense of further upcoming 5 months if you have already paid, that is one kind of a gain for you to be recorded on credit side. Like that, you have reduction in liability. Question is there in your mind how liability decreases? For example, sometimes it may happen creditors are not to be paid. Whatever the reason, your liability has decreased. That becomes gain for you. In this manner, you write all on debit side, you write all changes on credit side, do the total of higher side first. If your debit side total is more, write that, write the same figure on the credit side and then find the difference. If your difference appears on the debit side of your revaluation account, that is known as a profit, revaluation profit, which is to be distributed among the partners in the old profit and loss sharing ratio. So this difference, that what suppose 1 lakh rupees there to be distributed among the three partners, then 1 lakh in their old ratio, suppose 2:2:1 is the ratio, then you have to distribute on the manner. And that you transfer to partner's capital account when you prepare partner's capital account. Now, if it possible that your credit side difference arise, it become a loss for you. So loss also to distribute among the old ratio. If you see, the ratio is the same, that 2:2:1. So in this manner, one more account you have learned, that is revaluation account, which is compulsory for you to prepare. Now in next class, we will learn the journal entries regarding revaluation account. Now your today's homework is that draw the specimen and try to keep all the position in mind. So by doing revaluation account example, you can do it well. Any doubts or queries are there, you ask in the comment section. We can solve your difficulties. Thank you.